Hi, today we're going to show how to work with databases inside Anatella. As an analyst, at some point in time you will want to connect to a database and read data to integrate in your analysis. At the end, you might want to write the results back to the database for further use, for example, for targeting in a marketing campaign. Today I will show you how easy this is with Anatella. Let me first quickly show you how it works. We are in Anatella now and we are going to connect to the database using ODBC with the Read ODBC box. We just need to select the right connection and select the table we want to query. Let's run it and see. Yes, our data is flowing in, so it's successful. In the rest of the video, we will start from scratch and I'll show you how to get from there till reading and writing data back to the database. To get you up and running, we need to cover three things. One, installing the right drivers for your database. Two, configure the ODBC connection. Three, start using Anatella to read from and write to the database. So to start, let's first go to Windows and open the Windows ODBC Manager. To get there, we can type ODBC in the Windows Start menu and select ODBC Data Sources. Or we can open it from Anatella inside the Read ODBC box. Here we see the defined ODBC connections that are available on your machine. If you or your IT colleagues have prepared a connection, it will show here. I will assume that this connection does not exist and we still need to create it. This means I need to add a connection. The recommended way to define a connection is to use a system DSN. Then the connection is known for all users on this machine, but you need to have local admin rights to do this. If you don't have the rights and want to follow along with the video, you can use the User DSN tab. You create the ODBC connection only for your user. It's not recommended using the User DSN, especially when you're going to use your flows in production. You will run them as a different user and the ODBC connection is not known for that user. To create a new connection, we select Add. We can select different types of databases to connect to. If your database is not in the list, it means you still have to install the ODBC driver for your database on your machine. The easiest way to find the right driver is to go to the timi.eu website. Go to Downloads, scroll a bit down, there you'll get a list with all kinds of databases and you just need to select the right database for your case. Download the driver for your database, install it, reboot your machine and get back to this point. Now you should see your database in the list. From here, I assume you successfully installed a driver and you're able to select your database. So for this video, we will be using a database called Demo and it's a Postgres database. So we select the Postgres driver and continue. Here we need to enter all the credentials needed to connect to the database. If you need help, take a look at the Anatella manual where every database is covered in detail or contact your IT department for the right parameters. Now we can test our connection. We see it successful, so we can continue. Okay, I break the video very shortly here because I want to show you how it looks with a Microsoft SQL database. It's actually even more simple. You press a selector, wait until it populates with all the databases, you select the right database and you can continue. We are now at the point where the ODBC connection is defined. Now it's time to use it in Anatella. We go back to the Read ODBC box, press the Manage Connections and select an ODBC connection defined with Microsoft Windows ODBC Manager. In the drop-down, you can select the right database and you need to fill in your username and password. Now we can start querying the database and for simplicity we will be using the SQL wizard. On the left we have all tables in the database. This is a special demo database, so we don't have that many tables. On the right, we have all columns of the selected table. Now we select the columns relevant for us. And now let's have a look how this goes. Yes, nice, all our data is flowing in. So, reading data, check. Now we continue to writing data back to the database. Normally, our flow would be a bit more complex. We read data from the database and we use this data to get to some actionable insights. Here, we're just going to use that data and write it back in a new table in the database. First, we need to create a new table. And instead of writing a whole create table statement, we're going to use the create table box. The advantage, this box prepares the create table statement with the right data types based on the data in your flow. To use it, it's quite simple. We select the right connection, we enter our table name, we make sure the mode is on reading all rows, so we don't have any outliers. Now we go to the SQL statement tab to do a dry run. Here we see the complete create table statement. I like the statement as is, so I will apply it to the database and our table is created in the database. Our next step is inserting the data in that table. So inserting data into the database is more or less the same as reading data from the database. So here we select the right ODBC box, set the connection name and table name. In this case, we want to insert all columns into our table. Now let's run the flow start to end, and yes, it's running. Great. To summarize, we successfully created a connection to the database by installing and configuring everything for the ODBC connection. We read data from the database, we created a table, and we wrote data back to the database. Now it's up to you. Let us know in the comments field if this video was helpful for you. Thanks for watching this video, and if you like it, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to get more Anatella tips and tricks, subscribe to the channel. Ciao!